Hey guys, what's up? Top Gang on 123 once again with another video for you guys. In today's video, I'm showing you guys how to get a huge research bonus as USA and how to tech rush in Hearts of Iron 4 Vanilla. This works in single player and multiplayer since nothing really changes from single player to multiplayer. And I'm even going to show you how to get from a base 34% research bonus to an 84% research bonus on various things, which is absolutely OP and crazy. So what you're going to do first is we are in January 1st, 1936. The first thing you're going to do is go down to No National Focus, or Your Focus, whatever, and go to WPA. Now while you're doing this, you're also going to go in here, and for your first tech, you're going to research Electronical Mechanical Engineering. For the rest of these, I'm just going to go ahead and do these, not make you guys sit through them and get my game going, and then you'll kind of, I'll bring it back, show you guys what to do next when we get the political power. Alright guys, so we've just completed our very first tech bonus, and what you're going to do is go to Modify Government, and you're going to go down here to Industrial Concern, and you're going to get the General Electric to get a 10% bonus for electronical research. Now what this is going to do is it's actually going to reduce the time of this right here. Then you're going to go back in here, National Focus, Committee on Technocracy, or whatever that is. I'm tired, it's 10 o'clock at night, I can't speak right. Alright, so now you should have Committee on Technocracy, and then what you're going to do is go back to National Focus, you're going to abandon everything over here, and then you are going to go down Reaffirm Monroe Doctrine, and you're going to do exactly what I'm about to tell you. Alright guys, so we just got the Caribbean Sphere done, and I waited like 3 days and did no bonus. We'd actually get to 200 political power, and just to show you, here's what we're going to do next. Now we're going to go ahead down here and give refuge to German scientist and Italian scientist. Now around this time, you should have also finished our first mechanical computing. Now because you're already working on a base negative 21% research bonus, what you're going to do is go down to here and go to computing machine. Next thing you're going to do is keep going down and getting more political power, really any of those, and what you're going to do is continuously get the political power, and then you're going to go in here next, and you're going to get a political advisor, go ahead and get a silent workhorse. Alright guys, so we are in 1938 and we just finished our final advanced computing machine, and now we are going on a base 34% research bonus. I know you're thinking this is not much. Please watch this. This is how insane it really is. Now, we have the base 34, and I know I was saying I would show you how to get to 84. I have done various focuses, which I'm going to show you right now which one does what, to get 50% research bonuses. I did Fund the Navy, which gives bonuses to Marines, Transports, and Naval Doctrines. Then I came over here, did this one, so I get bonuses for artillery, support equipment, anti-tank, stuff like that. And then I even went down this one to get battleship bonuses, right? This is how insane it really is, okay? You see these artillery? This 1940 artillery, I can get in 20 days, 23 days. Haven't even researched, 23 days. I can get 1942 era anti-tank upgrades in 47 days. And if I had researched this previously and finished it in 39, I would get the newest anti-tank in 1943 in 1939. Same thing for regular artillery. And then we get down here, you know, it doesn't have anything for tanks, but naval. This is where it gets insane. 1944 era battleships, I can get in 130 days. In 1939, I will have 1944 era Illinois class battleships, and I'll even have plus 50 Navy XP to get an armor upgrade. That will rival a Japanese Super Yamamoto. Or, well, the regular Japanese Super Battleships, the first Yamamoto class. That will actually beat it. And it's even better if you do it for carriers. I can't remember what it is, but that's an idea. They cost the same research time. It takes 1,000 days for a Midway, 130 for a battleship with the bonuses. And then we get over here into doctrines. Look at this. It reduces doctrine time by ridiculous amounts. All of it's 32. It doesn't do anything for planes, doesn't do anything for air doctrine. But I mean, as you can see, if you do this correctly, it is the most overpowered focus you can ever imagine. And before people start thinking maybe I did cheats or something, I'm going to show you right here. Yes, I add 150 political power, but that's because when I picked off Landon, I didn't realize it got rid of my General Electric and threw on the Industrial. So all I did was put the 150 political power on for Electric. That's all I did. But you know what? you can do this yourself and just pick FDR instead. And this is also an ARCA thing, because you can see I didn't do any cheats since the beginning of the game. So you can see all you have to do is with political power add this Brooklyn Naval Yard, the Rock Island, General Electric, and then use the focus from the this thing over here, Committee on Technocracy, whatever. And then go down the engineering and get the last advanced computing machine. This gives you, like I said, a base 34 plus an extra 50 on different focuses. It is completely, and I mean totally insane, how much this will help you. And then it even goes more out of hand if you're actually on this and it starts sharing technology and everything. And you can then start boosting up your allies. You can join the allies and use it in there and start getting bonuses for 1944 era anti-tank and help them get it. And you're going to totally destroy anything the German player can send at you by 1941. Especially if you have these bad boys. Or this bad boy. Well, it doesn't work for this one, my bad. Wait, does it? No, it doesn't work for rocket artillery. But if you have this bad boy, or even this bad boy, which will actually do pretty good damage against tanks, if I remember right. Yeah, it's got ridiculous piercing. So, guys, thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed this. And remember, if you guys are going to use this in multiplayer and you actually want to advance your gameplay in Hearts of Iron, please don't forget to subscribe. Hey, it's July 4th, 1938. Awesome. Happy birthday, America. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. And if you did, don't forget to like and subscribe. I upload videos weekly. And if you want to see more videos like this, make sure you do subscribe to stay up to date on all future content. Thank you for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Stay awesome.